Okay, so today we're going to talk about why the notebook is such a bad depiction of Alzheimer's disease. My disclaimer is that this is a fine movie, okay? It's fine. Clearly this guy doesn't take no for an answer, which is a little bit of a concern, but the movie overall is fine. My problem with it is that it's a terrible depiction of Alzheimer's disease, and on a number of occasions, I've had people say to me, like, reference the notebook when they're talking about dementia and say, like, oh, this is what, you know, dementia's like. No, it is not. The main problem that I have with it is that one scene where, you know, the couple is dancing. Okay, spoiler alert. Spoiler alert. Okay, so the couple's dancing and she says to her husband, how long do I have before I, you know, go back into being confused? And so it's almost as though she's lucid, but she's so lucid that she actually knows she has Alzheimer's sometimes. Nobody has Alzheimer's sometimes. People can have more lucid moments, but you don't go from being like into dementia to totally not having any cognitive impairment. That's not real. And so 2 minutes later into them dancing, she's like, oh my God, who are you? And she's crying. She's freaking out because she doesn't know who her husband is. This is total nonsense. It's never happened. It never will happen. People do have more lucid moments, but to go from like having a lot of confusion to having no confusion like that and having an awareness of one's own disease, that's not how this works. So that is my real problem with this movie. That's not how Alzheimer's functions. Your loved one is not going to forget who you are. Your loved one's not going to like forget you or forget that they love you. They may just have trouble placing you on a timeline. If someone with dementia mixes you up with somebody else or assigns an identity to you that is not yours, it's not that they don't know you, it's not that they don't care, it's that they can't place you on a timeline that makes sense to them. So if they think that they're 45 years old, how is their adult child 55? Doesn't make sense, right? So sometimes they'll assign a different identity to you. Doesn't happen to everybody, and it doesn't happen all the time.